Welcome back everyone to English Wings. A letter to God part 2. So we have already discussed the part 1 of this chapter earlier. If you haven't watched the part 1 video, I will link the video link in the description box below so that you can watch the part 1 video as well. So let us start the part 2 video. CBSE class 10 English. So here is a theme of the story, because I have already discussed the introduction of the chapter in the part 1 video. So the theme of the story is the story A Letter to God by G.L. Fuentes highlights immense power in man's innocent faith in God. It teaches us that if man has childlike faith in God, he can accomplish anything considered impossible. If with this faith man asks God for help, God responds, though through his own peculiar channels, and fulfills man's any urgent legitimate desire. In this story, Lencho has been portrayed as a deeply spiritual man. He had immense faith in his God, goodness and generosity. After his crop was destroyed in a storm, he wrote a letter to God, requesting him to send him 100 pesos. His faith was rewarded. God helped him through the postmaster. Since the postmaster had only 70 pesos, he sent them all to maintain Lencho's faith in God. The innocent Lencho thanked God for his help. He also wrote another letter to God asking him to send 30 more pesos. He appealed to God to send the money through some other means, as he suspected the post office employees were crooks. So, theme of the story is that a man has immense power in his faith of God. So, यहाँ पे राइटर ने ये समझाने की कोशिश की है कि अ मैन बिकम्स अ चाइल्ड लाइक फिगर इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिज गॉड बिकॉज ही थिंक दैट द गॉड कैन अकम्प्लिश और फुलफिल एनी विश और एनी डिज़ायर. सो यहाँ पर लेंचो ने भी एक विश किया था कि दैट ही वॉन्टेड 100 पैसोस बिकॉज उसके क्रॉप इस ईयर डिस्ट्रॉय हो चुके थे. सो ही वॉन्टेड दैट 100 पैसो गॉड उसे सेंड करे. बट द लेटर पोस्ट मास्टर को वो लेटर मिल जाता है और पोस्ट मास्टर के पास सिर्फ 70 पैसोज होते हैं. सो ही सेंट 70 पैसोज टू द लेंचो. एंड लेंचो को लगता है कि नहीं, पोस्ट ऑफिस के एम्प्लॉयज हैं, दे आर क्रूक्स, दैट मीन्स दे आर फेक एम्प्लॉयज, दे डू सम रॉन्ग अकाउंट इन्फॉर्मेशन इन द एनी पर्सनस अकाउंट. सो ही ट्राइज दैट He pleads to God, he pleads that God please send the money through some other means. So the keywords are, first, conscience means moral sense, hailstorm that means storm, peso is a currency of Philippines or also in North America, amiable means friendly, correspondence means similarity, obliged means thankful, contentment means fulfillment, wrinkling creased, affixed, attach, crooks, hook. Crooks का मतलब hook भी होता है, और अगर एक person के adjective के रूप में use करे, that means a fake person who deceives other person, deceives. So, the story. But in the hearts of all, तो lastly हमने देखा था कि Lencho अपने family members को कहता है कि इस year हमें hungry ही रहना पड़ेगा because the crops are destroyed. So let us continue. But in the hearts of all who lived in that solitary house in the middle of the valley, there was a single hope from God. Don't be so upset, even though this seems like a total loss, remember, no one dies of hunger. That's what they say, no one dies of hunger. All through the night, Lencho thought only of his one hope, the help of God, whose eyes, as he had been instructed, see everything, even what is deep in one's conscience. Lencho was an ox of a man, working like an animal in the fields, but still he knew how to write. The following Sunday at daybreak, he began to write a letter which he himself would carry to town and place in the mail. It was nothing less than a letter to God. God, he wrote, if you don't help me, my family and I will go hungry this year. I need 100 peso in order to sow my field again and to live until the crop comes, because the hailstorm ... He wrote to God on the envelope, put the letter inside, and still troubled went to town. At the post office, he placed a stamp on the letter and dropped it into the mailbox. सो जब लेंचो कहता है अपने फैमिली मेम्बर्स को कि दैट दे विल हैव टू बी हंग्री फॉर द इंटायर ईयर, तो उनके फैमिली मेम्बर्स में एक होप आता है, होप दैट वॉज फ्रॉम गॉड. होप जो कि उन्हें एक ऐसा होप था जो कि उनमें ये बिलीव लगा रहा था कि गॉड जो है, जो कि हर चीज़ देखते हैं, ही विल श्योरली हेल्प देम बिकॉज नो वन डाइज ऑफ हंगर. ये उनका एक बिलीव था कि नो वन कैन डाई ऑफ हंगर, दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नेक्स्ट, लेंचो वॉज एन ऑक्स ऑफ अ मैन, दिस इज़ अ प्रोवर्ब, अ वेरी मैगजिम, वेरी कॉमन मैगजिम. दैट मीन्स अ पर्सन हु वर्क्स वेरी हार्ड टू अर्न मनी. Working like an animal in the field, but still he knew how to write. He was a farmer. He worked so hard in the fields, but still he knew how to write. So one day, on Sunday, he began to write a letter, which he himself carried down to the town. और उसमें उसने लिखा कि अगर आप हमारी help नहीं करते हो, my family and I will go hungry this year. हम इस साल hungry रह जाएंगे. तो मुझे 100 पैसों चाहिए तो मेरे फील्ड में फिर से वो सीड्स को सो करने के लिए, ताकि आई कैन ग्रो द न्यू क्रॉप अगेन. सो ही रोट द टू गॉड ऑन द एनवलप एंड वेंट टू द टाउन टू ड्रॉप इट इन द मेल बॉक्स. सो द एम्प्लॉयज हु वॉज अ पोस्टमैन एंड ऑल्सो हेल्प एट द पोस्ट ऑफिस वेंट टू हिज बॉस लाफिंग हर्चिली एंड शोड हिम द लेटर टू गॉड. Never in his career as a postman had he known that address. The postmaster, a fat, amiable fellow, also broke out laughing, but almost immediately he turned serious and tapping the letter on his desk commented, "What fate! I wish I had the fate of the man who wrote this letter, starting up a correspondence with God." So in order not to shake the writer's fate in God, the postmaster came up with an idea, answer the letter. But when he opened it, it was evident that to answer it, he needed something more than goodwill, ink and paper. But he stuck to his resolution. He asked for money from his employers. He himself gave part of his salary and several friends of his were obliged to give something for an act of charity. It was impossible for him to gather together the 100 pesos. So he was able to send the farmer only a little more than half. He put the money in an envelope addressed to Lencho and with it a letter containing only a single word as a signature God. So, यहाँ पर postman को जब वो letter मिलता है तो he see the address to God and he became confused कि ये किस type का letter है. So, उसने अपने और post office में अपने officer को दिखाया. He also broke out laughing. उसने भी विश्वास नहीं हुआ. वो उस इंसान का तारीफ करने लगता है कि what a faith. He believe in God blindly. He has a blind faith in God. काश मुझे भी ऐसा ही faith होता. So he started to help him. He asked for money from all his employees, all his friends to for an act of charity. So they only collected more than a half money and they put it in an envelope addressed to Lencho and wrote the signature God. Nothing else was written there. So on the Sunday, Lencho came a bit earlier than usual to ask if there was a letter for him. It was a postman himself who handed the letter to him. While the postmaster, experiencing the contentment of a man who has performed a good deed, looked on from his office. Lencho showed not the slightest surprise on seeing the money, such was his confidence, but he became angry when he counted the money. God could not have made a mistake, nor he could have denied Lencho what he had requested. Immediately, Lencho went up to the window to ask for paper and ink. On the public writing table, he started to write with much wrinkling of his brow, caused by the effort he had to make to express his ideas. When he finished, he went to the window to buy a stamp which he licked and then affixed to the envelope with a blow of his fist. The moment the letter fell into the mailbox, the postmaster went to open it, said, "God, of the money that I asked for, only 70 pesos reached me. Send me the rest, since I need it very much, but don't send it to me through the mail, because the post office employees are a bunch of crooks." Lencho. So, वो मनी देकर के कुछ भी सरप्राइज नहीं होता है, because he had such a overconfidence in God that he knew that God will send him the money. So, जब उन्हें लगता है कि 70 पैसे गॉड ने क्यों सेंड किया, क्योंकि गॉड तो कैलकुलेशन में रॉन्ग हो नहीं सकते हैं, तो ये कैसे हुआ, वाई दिस हैपेंड. सो ही ट्राइड टू राइट अ लेटर अगेन. ही रोट इन दैट 70 पैसे ही मुझे अभी तक मिला है, मुझे बाकी के भी पैसे चाहिए, बिकॉज आई नीड दैट वेरी मच, पर मुझे मेल से आप सेंड मत करना, बिकॉज पोस्ट ऑफिस इम्प्लॉयज आर अ बंच ऑफ क्रूक्स. सो ही डजेंट हैव फेथ इन द पोस्ट ऑफिस इम्प्लॉयज. द irony is that only that the persons who help them, he doesn't have faith in them only. So if you all like the content, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. In the next video, we will discuss the NCERT solutions of this chapter. Till then, stay tuned.